List with the race for speakership in the 11th Parliament. The battle lines were drawn long time ago, but today they became a little bit intense after the Kamuli Women MP, Rebecca Kadaga, chose to go and register her interest to run for the speaker position as flag bearer within the National Resistance Movement immediately after swearing in as new MP. The chairperson, rather member of the Chief Executive Committee of the National Resistance Movement, Dr. Chris Bariumusi, also expressed dismay and displeasure at what he described as chaotic campaigns by supporters of Kadaga and her former deputy, Jacob Olanya, for the job. Let's have the details.
At 10:30 a.m., the Speaker of the 10th Parliament, Rebecca Kadaga, took oath as the Kamuli District Woman MP for the eighth time.
I, Rebecca Kadaga, swear in the name of the Almighty God that I'll be faithful and bear true allegiance to the Republic of Uganda, and that I'll preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution. So help me God.
Kadaga, who joined Parliament in 1989 in the National Resistance Council, becomes the longest-serving MP in the 11th Parliament. She promised more services to the people of Kamuli.
There are many things we agreed to do. There are things they talked to me during the campaign. Issues of increasing the number of technical schools in the district, increasing the water. I've already been doing the water issues. I'm supposed to ensure there is a solar lighting in all the trading centers in the district, and of course to improve on girl child education.
Shortly after swearing in, Kadaga announced that she will now embark on fighting to retain the speakership.
The next step is to put in my request, put in my notice for the speakership. Yes, that's the next step.
When are you doing it?
We have time. You'll hear when I've done it.
She promised new MPs more facilities to improve their work, such as office space.
We shall continue to work on improving the facilities at Parliament. In 2 years' time, this building should be ready so that we have somewhere to sit. If the COVID pandemic ends, we shall be able to sit comfortably inside a chamber seating 600 people. We are also working on the issues of office accommodation. We are going to improve on the committee system. Be more efficient.
The NRM Central Executive Committee yesterday met at State House in Entebbe to discuss the speakership elections. According to the NRM Vice Chairperson for Western Uganda, Dr. Chris Bariumusi, who attended the meeting, the NRM top organ expressed displeasure with the bickering and the drama surrounding the speakership elections.
We expressed some level of displeasure about the way the campaign was unfolding, because you are in the position of a speaker and deputy speaker. Those positions are never contested for. Actually, the parliamentary settings, we say a speaker is dragged to the chair. Although the trend which we're observing was a little bit unacceptable, but luckily this was halted. And I think the aggressive campaigning and the hostilities which were being generated by this campaign somehow subsided.
Bariumusi said SEC would vet all aspirants for speaker and deputy speaker and form a consensus on one candidate for each position. But the NRM parliamentary caucus, which is slated to meet on May the 23rd, will be given a chance to decide should SEC fail to resolve the matter.
The Electoral Commission of NRM, starting today or tomorrow, will issue a notice of expression of interest, so that all those who are interested in contesting for these two positions apply to the Electoral Commission, and the names will then be forwarded to the Central Executive Committee, and then we shall examine these names and vet them on Saturday. That's when we are going to sit and make a consideration. But should it happen that we do not reach consensus of coming up with only one name for either position, then we may refer the matter to the parliamentary caucus, which is scheduled to sit on Sunday, the 23rd, and then voting can take place.
Kadaga wants a third mandate at the helm of parliament, while Jacob Olanya seeks the top parliamentary seat for the first time. This story was filed by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.